Tanisha is the culprit here.
Anyway, so coming back to here, so we were looking at different types of seeds, and then out of these there were these two types, monocot and dicot, and we were looking at the structure of one of the dicot seed as an example, that is bean seed. And if you remember, any type of seed, like if you are talking, we have three structures mainly involved in it, that is seed pod, endosperm, and the embryo. So three structures are being present, and within those three structures there can be subparts. So seed coat is the outermost covering. So like if you remember, in this case this dark green is the outermost cover, and here it is shown in kind of greenish color. But in kidney bean set seeds, what we have is dark brownish seed. This can be unripe one, but in kidney bean set bean seeds we have a dark brownish color. Testa and tegmen. Testa is the outermost hard covering. Tegmen is the inner part of the seed coat, which is thin membranous covering. So that is testa and tegmen. And usually their function is to allow the water absorption from those layers inside. Then there is something called as micropyle, which is like if you remember this particular ovule structure, we had looked at micropyle was the structure from which pollen tube had entered the ovule or the embryo sac, and it fertilizes with the female gametes. So that was pollen tube from which from one of the end it enters the embryo sac, and that particular part was micropyle. This micropyle is present in the seed as well. So like here there is a small opening inside the seed which is acting as a micropyle, and whenever we soak the seeds in water, like for sprouting or for cooking purpose, the water mainly enters through the micropyle because it's small pore like structure which is remaining with the seed, and ideally it was the entry point for the pollen tube during the ovule stage. Now it has turned into seed stage. So that is micropyle. Then what we have next is the hilum. Again, hilum was the connection joint between the ovule and the what we say, the funiculus or the stem of the ovule, right? So this hilum in this case is equivalent to the navel in the human, where the umbilical cord is attached. Okay, fine. So this hilum, now again, I don't remember if I had shown you earlier. Let me show you that hilum in ovule. So for example, yeah, this part, which was a connection joint between the ovule and this placenta like structure, which is called as funiculus, that connection point was called as hilum. And this hilum is also present in the seed here. That is where the seed is going to break open into two parts. Yes, please. So that is the hilum portion, micropyle portion, seed pod, that is testa and tegmen part. Now, hilum is the oval scar on the concave side of the seed, that is the inner part of the seed, and it is actually indicating the part where it is attached to ovary. So that means when the ovule was present, like we know ovary can have many ovules, and it is attached to ovary with different in different position. That is what we had seen in terms of placentation also, like within one ovary, depending on how many ovules are present, the placentation can be different, and the connection point between the ovule and ovary, that is what is indicating the hilum part. And below the seed pod there are two thick cotyledons which ideally contain the food for the embryo to protect it. Hilum function is just to connect ovule to ovary.
So it's like a tube.
Yeah, and that is when it is saying It is also equivalent to the navel in human. Like we also have a navel point, every human being, and that is the point of attachment of the umbilical cord, that is through the mother's uterus. So cotyledons are these ones which are kind of relatively. Yes, that is placenta or umbilical cord. So these are the cotyledons which are shown in light green color here, and they are nutrient rich and they are going to provide the nutrition to this embryo. Embryo is the part of the seed which is going to grow into a new plant. So that is the embryo part. Okay, does anyone have any question here up till now? Okay, so if there are no questions, then we can move forward. So this part we had not seen earlier. So on separation of cotyledons, that is when you separate those two cotyledons, the tiny embryo is present inside, attached to one of the cotyledon. So what you see in these diagrams, this tiny embryo is present in between two cotyledons. Otherwise, same is the case here also. When you open up the seed, do you know almond can be separated, cashew can be separated, chana can be separated?
Chana,
chickpea or pea or gram, the half of it. So that is what is this half cotyledon. So they have a small embryo present within them. And small, like kind of very tiny particle, like that is what is your embryo. Not your embryo, but the embryo of that particular seed. So the embryo in general is divided into two parts. One is called as radical and the other one is called as plumule. Radical is the one which grows into root. So you have to remember by this analogy of the letter RR, radical root. So radical is the lower part of the embryo, which is growing into root. And plumule is that part of the embryo which grows into shoot or grows into the leaves and branches. So if you look here, this lower part which has, if this is the embryo, this part has grown into the radical, that is kind of shown in orangish or reddish color. And the upper part is the plumule part. So this leaf looking like structure, that is the plumule part. Same is the case here, more clearly visible. The end part of the embryo is the radical and the upper part is known as plumule. Now, these two structures we will see as well because they will come later. But what simply you need to remember is the upper part which grows into shoot is plumule. The lower part which grows into root is radical. Now, the plumule consists of a short stem with a pair of tiny leaves. That's what I said. Plumule is the upper part which will give rise to a stem and leaves. But at the start, there will be a very short stem and a pair of tiny leaves and a growing point between them. That means, yeah, in video, surely you had seen that. So this is what is the plumule part. And epicotyle is a small shoot which gave rise to the entire plant shoot system. So epicotyle is that small shoot. So at the start, so like how we also have, we have like sperm and ova, then we have embryo, then we have fetus, then baby, adult. These are different stages, right, of the same cellular material or multicellular organism. Similarly, that way, this is what is called as the earlier version of the plumule. It's called as epicotyle, right? Epi is top. Cotyle refers to cotyledon. So the top part of that cotyledon, which is growing into the plumule or which is growing into the leaf, that is what is epicotyle. And the primary root will emerge from the first, during germination. That is hypocotyle. So that is hypo means below, and that is what is the lower part of that cotyledon, which is growing into root system. That is what will be called as hypocotyle.
So hypocotyle grows into
shoot. sorry, hypocotyl into root. So if we talk of epicotyl, so earlier this whole part, upper part is called as plumule, lower part is called radicle. This plumule will develop into epicotyl, which is the upper part of this, which will grow into the leaf and stem. And hypocotyl, which is ultimately a part of radicle, that will grow into the primary roots and so on. And that is the one which will give firmness to a plant in the soil. So that is all about this bean seed.
This part is basically only in bean seed, or they are found in all the seeds?
All the examples of bean seed. And even in dicot, you will find all of these parts. They might be arranged little differently. Like for example, in this gram seed, right? Gram seed diagram, or maybe germination. Yeah. Here also you can see, this is not good enough. Yeah, you can see it probably here, right? This is the seed coat. This is the hilum, micropyle next to it. And what this is at the center, when you open up the seed, you get these cotyledons, and then seed coat is outside this cotyledon, radicle and plumule. And that is what will turn into your hypocotyl and epicotyl. So the structurally, like name wise, they will remain same. Just the arrangement will be little different depending on the shape of the seeds. Okay, now this part I am not going to revise or not even going to speak much about, because this we had seen.
Oh.
Please sit properly. Then you can go home. Yeah, that I don't mind at all. So there is something called endosperm. Like I said, out of the three parts, that is seed coat, embryo and endosperm. We have seen seed coat, we have seen embryo. Now the endosperm is that nutritious part, right? That you can revise on your own. This is nothing great. It is just located below the seed coat. It is also forming the cotyledon part in the later stages. And where it is coming from, if you remember, this triploid nucleus. So this is going to give rise to embryo. Integument will give rise to your seed coat. And this triploid nucleus, which is shown here, is going to give rise to the endosperm, which is the nutritious part of the seed. So these are the different part.
So later it turns into a cotyledon.
Cotyledons will always be there, but in addition to cotyledon, there will be another nutritious layer, which is called as endosperm.
Oh, this is a layer.
Yeah. So this part, outermost, yeah, around the cotyledon. That is what is endosperm. Like this cotyledon are ultimately part of that nutrition, which is endosperm. Okay, so this you can do on your own. There is nothing great in terms of difficulty at all. So this should be easier. Yeah, one thing in case of coconut is the liquid endosperm. So the nutritious tissue is that liquid that you get in the coconut. Yeah, so that is just one additional fact that I need to mention. Now, the second type of seed, that is maize grain, which is monocotyledonous. So let me show you the diagram first. I'm sure everyone has seen the maize grain. Like in reality, how does it look like? And that is what is shown on the left hand side in terms of complete diagram, and the section of it, that is the vertical section, is shown in this diagram. So again, like I said, any seed will always have these three part: seed coat, endosperm, and the embryo. So what you see in this maize grain, like without going into the description here, I'm going to directly talk from this diagram. So this outermost part here that you see, which is kind of thickened, is called aleurone layer in maize. And the reason why it is called so, because it has high amount of protein present inside. So that aleurone layer is protein rich component of the seed coat. This part is the endosperm. Endosperm, again, we get it from the triploid nucleus. Cotyledons are present close to the embryo. So this part is embryo, this part is cotyledon, which both endosperm as well as the cotyledon, they contain nutrition. Cotyledons, they fall off when the embryo is growing further. And this endosperm and cotyledon, they are separated by this middle layer, which is epithelial layer present. And that separation, now in this diagram, the only fault is this epithelium is shown a little far away from the embryo. Otherwise, it is very close. And quite a lot of it is endosperm. So whatever taste that you get of the maize grain or of the corn, that is because of this endosperm material present in the corn, right? Or in the grains of those corns. So that is the aleurone layer, epithelium, then endosperm and cotyledon. Now specifically in case of maize, this cotyledon is also known as scutellum. Scutellum, where is the scutellum? Here it is. Yeah. So embryo, it consists of one large shield-shaped cotyledon, and it is also known as scutellum in case of maize. So that is what is the scutellum.
I didn't understand aleurone
layer. Aleurone layer is just the outermost covering of the endosperm layer.
So it's just like a protection.
Yeah. And it is rich in the protein content.
How much protein does this
need? Does this need in the sense?
Even in cotyledon, there is protein and nutrition.
Yes.
Even in endosperm.
But this is protein rich. That means there will be higher amount of protein present in this compared to other biomolecules. That is what it means by protein rich.
Sir, what did you say? Like, which part gives the taste of the grain?
Endosperm.
Oh,
because like depends, no, if it is sweet or kind of not sweet or just kind of raw grainy taste, that is because of these endosperm present in it. And you know it, it's like quite huge, huge in the sense compared to this embryo, this part is much bigger in the same seed. And you must have seen this part as well, which is kind of a little whitish dot on that maize grain. That is where the embryo is located as well. Okay, so aleurone layer, endosperm, cotyledon, also called as scutellum, and cotyledon and endosperm, they are separated by this epithelial layer, which is just a kind of separate nutrition for the seed as whole and for the embryo. And this part, which is kind of shown just lines, that is your embryo of the maize grain. Now in this case, again, there are two parts, upper part plumule, lower part radicle. Just a little different structure that is present. Plumule is covered, that is the leafy shoot is covered with a structure that is called as coleoptile, and the radicle is covered with coleorhiza. So these are the two additional structure compared to the regular seed present in all the other type of seed that we had seen previously. So radicle again will grow into root, plumule will grow into shoot. Plumule is covered with coleoptile, radicle is covered with coleorhiza. So that is the whole structure of the maize grain present here, right? I hope I have not missed on any point. Yeah, and again, one of the fact of the maize grain, because it is a grain, if you remember from the diagrams which I had drawn on the board, the fruit wall, that is the pericarp, and the seed coat, they are kind of fused in whole of this grain, right? So whatever you see here, where is it? Here, this one, the outermost kind of white, or not white, the black line, that is actually the merging of the seed coat, that is testa and tegmen, like you have seen in case of this one.
No, this
yeah, that I have, yeah, So that one is called as just the seed coat, which is the fusion of the fruit wall and the ovules wall, that is the seed coat. Yeah, and that's all of it. I don't think I have missed on any part. Yeah, endosperm has a lot of nutrition, including starch and so on, that we know it already. So that is all about the maize grain. Does anyone have any question here? Looking at the diagram or seeing any other questions related to it? Anyone? Okay, so if there are no questions, no. Then it will come show me here. Ovi, you want to go and wash your face?
Yeah, sir.
Then go and wash your face and come back.
Okay.
In 2 minutes.
Okay, sir.
And try to make less noise while you get up and sit.
Yeah, I think.
Then you may not enter next time my class.
Okay,
sir. Sir, there is a sink in the labs area.
Sorry?
There's a sink in the labs area.
Yeah. But yeah, okay. So now just a quick kind of quiz for all of you so that you will be a little more interactive. Let me start with Pratham. Pratham?
Yeah, sir.
Can you tell me what is the structure number 2?
Radical.
And then what will be 3?
Hilum.
Look at the arrow points exactly. Or maybe someone else then. Anvesha. Anvesha can't hear you.
So can you hear me now?
Yeah, yeah.
So even I have the same confusion. I also thought that was radical.
Okay, so let me show you. You look at this diagram where the 2 is pointing, where 3 is pointing. I will show you this diagram again.
Is it epicotyl?
What is this?
Oh, hypocotyl.
Yeah. So like I said, obviously the end part is the radical. Hypocotyl is the part which will give rise to the primary roots. So now when we talk of those primary roots, it's not always from the end, right? They can also come from a little lower part of the root and then they can go kind of perpendicular to the axis, right? So that way this is the hypocotyl part and the radical part. So that label here, where is it? Yeah, this 2 is the hypocotyl and 3 is your radical part. Okay. Then next, let me ask Indira.
Sir, so one is epicotyl.
One we are yet to reach, sir.
2 is epicotyl. No, 2 is hypocotyl.
Yeah.
So which one? Third one.
First one.
That is the shoot part. Wait, that is epicotyl.
Yes, Indira, yeah, what is it?
So which one? 4?
First. Yeah, first one. You went on mute again.
Sir, epicotyl?
Yeah, epicotyl, precisely. And if it would have been pointing at this part, that is this leaf looking like structure, then it would have been, which one? This one?
I don't remember its name. I know.
Something starts with P, plumule, right? So that would have been plumule, epicotyl, hypocotyl, and radical. Okay, yes. Tell me, what is fifth one?
Seed coat.
Ha ha ha. What are the 2 different types of seed coat?
Testa and tegmen.
Correct. Vasisht, what is the part labeled 4?
Testa.
Vasisht.
Sir, can I answer the next question if there is one, because I'm having some trouble right now.
Sorry? I didn't get it. What
can
did
I
you
answer mean? The next question?
Because... Okay. Because, okay. I can't hear you. Its voice is breaking. Any which way. Akshat, what is the part number 4?
Sir,
say it, Akshat.
Sir, in 5 would be the seed port, but I don't know 4.
Okay. Anadya. 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 Anadya is not there. Okay, gone. Adi, what do you think is the part number 4? Mr. Adi?
It's the endosperm.
Okay, endosperm. Otherwise, in majorly, what it would be called as? Yes, Ananya?
Cotyledon.
Cotyledon, right? Majorly, it is called as cotyledon. You can also write endosperm, which is a bigger part or bigger unit of it, right? Now, in the second diagram, that is of the maize grain, Rayansh, tell me, what is A? Rayansh, and I guess Kabir also there.
Yes, sir.
What is part which is labeled A? Either of you can tell. Hello?
Sir, is it seed coat?
Yeah, it is seed coat, but it has a very specific name there. Who said, can I try? Ruhani, yes.
Even I thought it was seed coat.
Sir?
Go ahead, go ahead.
Fruit wall, maybe?
Not really. It is pointing at these double line inner like layer.
Oh, some layer. Something from A.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Pratham.
Sir, epithelial layer.
No.
It's the protein layer.
Yeah, it's the protein rich layer. What is it called?
The one I asked about a bit.
Oh, just now.
I don't remember its name though.
Okay, let me show you the diagram. Or shall I tell you?
Does
it's called aluron layer.
Yeah.
Okay. See here, this aluron layer.
Oh, yeah.
Right. So that is aluron layer. What is D? D, let me ask now. Ananya Jogdekar.
What Jogdekar?
Ananya. What Jogdekar? There is only
one.
I got it like 4 times right now. What?
You said Ananya.
Why is everyone saying?
D is endosperm.
D is endosperm. Shiv, what is B?
The cotyledon, right?
Yeah, what is it called specifically? Something that starts with S, C.
Oh. Wait. What?
Anyone remembers it?
B, right? B?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What is it?
Isha? Cotyledon.
Cotyledon, but what is the other name?
I don't know.
Scutellum. See, again.
Scutellum.
Here, this one is shown cotyledon. Where is it? This one. Where is the spelling? Yeah, here. Scutellum.
So, the other thing is endosperm and that is scutellum.
So,
and together at the cotyledon.
Yeah. Label C. Ashi.
So, I don't know.
Sir, is C pointing to the U thing or the outside thing?
So, me ideally it should be pointing here where my cursor is. Yeah.
Okay, so can I try?
Yeah.
Is it the radical? Maybe?
Yes, radical. And if it is pointing at this outermost layer, no? Outermost as in this U-shaped outer part. That would be coleoryza. Similarly, if it is pointing at this point, then it will be plumule. And if it is pointing at this outer, like ulta U, that will be coleoptile. So, depending on where it is pointing, we can always... Yeah, you have to
remember. I don't think... I mean, I don't remember learning about the Nietzsche wala, Gloria what?
Coleoryza.
What is that?
This is the covering around the root or that is the radical, and coleoptile, which is the covering around the plumule.
Oh, okay.
So that is what, these are two additional structures present in this maize grape. Okay. So if anyone has any question can ask, otherwise we will stop here for today. Tomorrow we will start with germination, and that should be the last class of this chapter. It's very, very easy. Now you don't even have to apply your brain at all to
sir,
this.
Sir, after the seed cast, can we do something human?
Yeah, we can do.